inspire, empower, grab your girls and soar a little higher, unlock the fire in you, cause real women don't bitch, no, real women don't, 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 real women don't bitch.
Hey, 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 thank you for joining me on the Real Women Don't Bitch podcast. This is your proud host, August Crenshaw, aka Mrs. Raw, Real, and Relentless. I am the number one advanced mental conditioning specialist for entrepreneurs because building mental muscle is necessary in order to implement successful business strategies. This show has been created for the woman who is not excuse-driven and needs help building a profitable business. I will be interviewing women from various fields who are willing to break the silence on struggles that specifically affect female entrepreneurs. Welcome to a show where I and guest speakers from time to time share our methods that help us beast our business no matter what is going on in our lives. Whether you are an online or brick and mortar business owner, this show is for you. We will hit every angle, personal, professional, and spiritual. Why? Because on any given day, you get hit with shit from a scenario involving one, more, or perhaps all of the above. It all impacts you and your mindset towards your business. I have made it my personal mission to provide a space where we dive deep into the BS we face on a day-to-day basis. All right, now, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending on what part of the world you're in. What's going on, everybody? I am in a great mood. I am excited about the future. I have a lot of great things coming my way, but I just had one hell of a week as far as dealing with an emotional roller coaster is concerned. And I'm gonna be honest with you, even though I'm bold and I say any and everything that's on my mind, that doesn't mean that I'm not strategic and that sometimes I'm not cautious or careful about when I release information. And sometimes I deliberately refrain from speaking about things because of the potential static it can cause. And when I say static, you know, I'm talking like the streets, you know, some issues that could come up. Because even though a person could be wrong as two left feet, I don't have time to get distracted by somebody trying to respond or doing something else. And there are other times when I'm like, look, a person, they tripped. They did this in the open. I don't care what they think. I don't care how they feel. I'm going to put it all out there on blast and I go from there. And so I wanted to share something with you because right now we are in that place. We are in a season where people are looking for answers. I mean, this is not, it's not rocket science. People are looking for answers. And right now, the coaching industry is still booming. Now, a lot of these upper echelon coaches don't have these real expensive packages anymore. But the point is that they're out there. And many of you are like, okay, I got to do something because your back is against the wall. With the last bit of money you have, it's like, do I sign up for this academy or do I sign up for this coaching package? Do I join this group, this mastermind? And I just want to remind you all that no matter what happens, to trust God and keep the main thing the main thing. I had to go through something that someone went through with me. It was well over a year ago. I met this woman and I was like, I want to help your organization. I just really feel like I'm supposed to help you. I want to contribute to your organization. I want to talk to you about giving you some services for free because I just want to honor everything about, you know, what you're doing. And when I talked to the woman and, you know, explained to her how I could help, she told me, you know, and you could see that there was a little bit of hesitancy in her mind, but her heart told her go, that she was like, I want to let you help me. But the last person that told me this, I shared a lot with them and they took advantage of me.
And to make a long story short, they were going to supposed to help her with her book idea. She told them what the whole outline should be. It was her story. This was perfect. Out of all of the people to help coach her through it, it made sense that it would be this woman because she had been through something similar. So she understood her pain. They were going to be, you know, in this together. And as fast as they had that conversation on a Friday, that Monday, the woman, because she had more money, had already hired someone to make up a mock copy with her concept and put a post out telling people they could pre-order her book that she was going to be working on writing. And just like that, that woman's dreams were just splattered across the pavement, ran over, and then somebody hit reverse and ran back over it again. So when I come along and I say I'm here to genuinely help and I'm speaking a language that shows that I'm really there, she was apprehensive, but I thank God not so much that she didn't allow me to help her, because what ended up coming out of that relationship, number one, was a full-blown proprietary process, because she had been doing what she was doing in her organization, but she was kind of, you know, freestyling it. And I'm like, yeah, but at the end of the day, it does something to your credibility, and it also does something for the results for your people when you begin to recognize patterns and you have a duplicatable process. So that's number one. And I mean, I literally took her through it to the point I was like, okay, and so this is one, this is two, based on, and it was based on what she was telling me. It's not like I made up something for her. I kept asking her questions to extract data from her to then say, this is how this translates into a program. And now she's back full force with that book idea, completely different concept, but of course she ain't sharing it with nobody. The only person I've actually gotten a chance to hear a snippet of it, and it brought me to tears. But I'm just grateful that she didn't let a negative situation determine how her mind felt about leadership. And I literally just had to go through the same thing. I had a bit of a situation online where the irony is the same woman who said I'll never tolerate any form of abuse spoke to me in the most abusive tone that you could ever imagine. And I'm going to do it later. You guys know how I am. I will like go through post and like read through the dialogue so you all can see the level of dysfunction. But it was just so awful to hear this woman speak to me in the manner in which she did, and to say she doesn't have any regrets, you know, to publicly demean me and say shit like reading is fundamental. And I'm sitting there laughing at myself saying you didn't even read what you wrote, because if you did, you would be able to put the two dots together to understand why I, you know, why I thought you meant one thing, even though you say you meant something else. And so all of that happened right before I had this amazing encounter with the woman that I had an opportunity to do a collaboration with overseas. And if I had allowed that old tape, because you guys got to understand the things that you have gone through, they don't go anywhere. They keep coming back. They just manifest in different forms. And so the level of disrespect and disgust that I have dealt with, two areas we can say, coaches in the industry or people that just are in positions of leadership or influence, abusing that and being very condescending towards people, is something that I run into periodically. There have been times when I've had to look at myself and say, well, August, what's attracting that to you? Because, and you know, I have to take accountability if I got in a bad relationship with a coach because I was so excited to, you know, get their results versus me verifying and really sitting in whether or not the product or service that they had to offer was something that I really needed, you know. But I'm past all of that. So this time I got the wolf in sheep's clothing. You know, here we are. I'm seeing you the way you're presenting yourself, the stuff you're talking about. I've invested in your lower ticket options to get a feel for you and how you serve, and thinking that you were one way only for you to turn around and flip it back and be another. But I've learned that I'm the governor of my happiness, the governor of my joy, the governor of my peace of mind, the governor of my life. And so every single time I run into some idiotic or silly acting supposed to be grown person, I can't allow myself to get distracted by the, oh my God, but I trusted them and I thought that this was going to work. You all have to realize that more often than not, you're going to get the counterfeit first. It's kind of like that. Even like, think about it with dating. Most of you who, if you're blessed and you're with the man of your dreams, there was an asshole that came before that. Now, some of you may be lucky. You know, you dated that one guy. As a matter of fact, I got this one girlfriend. She told me she dated a guy, and because she wouldn't, you know, give it up to him back when she was in college, she was like, ain't nobody gonna wait on you. I mean, just dissed her. You know, he was kind of forceful. She didn't get raped or anything, but he was kind of forceful with letting it be known that, you know, you need to give it up. And when she didn't, he just drove her home and was like, ain't nobody gonna wait on you. And never said anything else to her again. But then after that, she met the husband that she's with now, who did love her and did wait. And so I've been married before. And the first guy, he was a wolf in sheep's clothing. Totally happy that I'm not with him. It ain't about dissing him, but he's not fucking marriage material. And after going through three wives, I think that that already pretty much says it. One before me, and then one after me. But now the man that I'm with came very shortly after him. And we've been together since 2006. So, hey, you know, we've been together a solid 14 years and married 10 of those in October. And so don't allow yourself to get into this position where the experiences that you deal with people, that you basically take it as a loss. If you dwell on it, if it alters your mood, if it discourages you from investing or makes you feel like you don't want to be around anybody at all, and you go into this whole, that's why entrepreneurship is, you know, a lonely road and all of that stuff. If you take on that, then you've taken the experience as a loss. Whereas if you say, oh, wow, that was crazy. Okay, let me make sure I never do that, or I pay attention to these behaviors in the future, or I don't tolerate this, and you learn something from it. We have to be very mindful of our energy, especially in a season like right now where they're already trying to stress us out with the BS with COVID and all of the stuff going on with the protesting and police brutality and just all of the tricks that are going on with the money and the economy. You have to have a level mind. And so I know that things seem really awful right now. I know that it's a lot to take in, but trust me, this right now is a time where you push, and those of us who don't quit, who stay hopeful, who keep the pace and keep going, we are going to be the ones who are going to look up and say, OM to the fucking G. Look at how I came out on the other side of this. We are in a new world. We're experiencing a new life. And a lot of people, unfortunately, are going to get wiped out in the wash. But many of us will still be standing when it's over. And the one thing you can't do is allow a counterfeit experience with someone to totally become your benchmark for how you review relationships in the future. So, I mean, those of you that are on different platforms, I would love to hear your feedback. You know, have you had to deal, you know, with betrayal and loss in business or, you know, spirituality or what have you? And you've had to go through these issues with influencers or leaders abusing their power or, you know, belittling people, having a condescending nature and just actually being more damaged than they are good for the people. I would love to hear your story too. I would love to know what has happened with you. Now, on another note, let's not forget, the Authentic Collective Academy is moving in full swing. And for those of you that are looking for a great program that is loaded with real information, with my presence there to help you and guide you so that you could get this stuff together and come out solid on the other end of 2020, then head on over to aclive.co and join the Authentic Collective Academy and get some real coaching and get you some real answers. All right. I love you all. I'm outie. Deuces.
Thank you for joining me today. Remember to cultivate a mindset that is biased towards taking action. No bitching, whining, or complaining. Here, our mantra is, real women don't bitch, we get shit done. See you next week as I continue to bring you what you need to keep your head in the game and beast your business. Don't forget to hit subscribe and leave us a 5-star review. Would you like a specific topic covered? Have a question you would like answered live? Then head on over to realwomendontbitchpodcast.com. Subscribe to my email list, hit me up, and I got you. Interested in being a guest speaker? You walk the walk? Then you can sign up on the website too. This is your number one advanced mental conditioning specialist for entrepreneurs, Mrs. Raw, Real, and Relentless. Signing out. Deuces!
Inspire, empower, grab your girls and soar a little fire in you.